I'd also implore leaders to focus on being eco-centric leaders versus ego-centric leaders.
We don't really have time. Science is very clear about it. The catastrophes and the crisis that we are living every day is so clear about it.
We have the largest youth generation ever.
In the beginning, in the previous draft, there was this mention about intergenerational terms and intergenerational aspects, and we are not seeing that anymore. And that's a little bit worry, especially for young people, when we want to address this as an intergenerational equity.
There are still some elements that are missing on the first draft of the post-2020 Global Biodiversity Framework, as a stronger language on human rights and clear definitions and safeguards for the new terms.
My expectation is that we be ambitious and we do what is needed, not necessarily what's feasible.
We think that intergenerational equity would be something that would bring the framework forward.
This is really an incredible opportunity to tackle the biodiversity and nature crisis.
I would very much want to see more of the youth inclusion in all the political processes and decision making, and that is making these processes more open and truly inclusive.
Young people do not just want to hear about the framework. We want to be part of the framework. We want to know the framework and connect with it at a deeper level so that we are meaningfully able to contribute to the transformation.
This is the only way we're really truly gonna be transformative.
Nature positive by 2030 specifically.
Terms like nature positive or net zero or nature-based solutions need social and biodiversity safeguards that to ensure that we don't allow for further greenwashing or perverse offsetting schemes or monoculture plantations.
If you can get those voices somehow magnified on a large scale level, then it will make a big difference for actually solving the problems on the ground.
We really need to put equity and rights at the core of this framework, at the core of sustainability.
The language of the framework must guarantee, clearly explain, the flow of capacity, finances, and knowledge to youth, especially those from disadvantaged and vulnerable communities across the world.
We need to take bold, radical, and big steps.